Hey editors, in this video we will create smooth modern logo animation from scratch inside Fusion. By the end you will be able to animate your own logo and give it the life it truly deserves. So let's get started. Just right click your footage and choose open in Fusion. Alright, I have split my logo into two separate pieces as PNG files, so I can use the playhead as the main star of the animation. Let's bring in the playhead first. But here's a tip. You don't want to just drag and drop the PNG from the media pool. That can cause many issues later if you want to turn this into a preset or macro. I learned that the hard way. Instead, we are going to use a loader node. Press Shift plus Space and add a loader node. Now find the PNG, click open, and it's loaded. First, let's connect our loader node to the media info so we can see it on the final preview. And Fusion will automatically create a merge node and connect everything for us. So let's start and animate the playhead first. Select your loader nodes and click on the transform node. Select the transform node and in the inspector panel, nudge the playhead a little off center. And make sure you are at frame 0. Reduce the size to 0 and add a keyframe. Then move 5 frames forward and increase the size to around 1.2. Move another 15 to 20 frames forward and bring the size back to 1. This gives our playhead a nice little pulse effect. Make the playhead pop a little by adding a soft glow around it. I'm going to move the loader node upward to make some room. With the loader node selected, press Shift plus Space and add a soft glow node. First, set gain to 0. And the blend to about 0.9. Then go to frame 5 and add a keyframe for the gain. Move 15 frames forward and increase the gain to around 0.6. This will make the glow appear gradually. Now select your transform node and add a brightness contrast node. We will tweak the settings in just a moment, but first, let's bring in the second part of our logo. Make sure you don't have any node selected. Then press Shift plus Space and add another loader node. Find the PNG for the second part of your logo and click open. Let's preview it in the left viewer. Alright, press Shift plus Space again and add a soft glow node. Then add a transform node after it. Now let's connect the second part of the logo to the main pipeline. Grab a merge node. Connect the playhead nodes to the green input. And the second part of the logo to the yellow input. Then connect this merge node to the previous one. Let me bring the glow to 0 for now. And position this part of the logo. Perfect. Now we want the playhead to slide over to the left. As it moves, we should see the rest of the logo getting revealed. So basically, as it moves, more of the logo is uncovered. This adds a really clean look to the animation. Now let's click on the transform node for the playhead. I will jump to frame 40 and add a keyframe on the center X value. Then move forward about 20 frames and just slide the center X value over so the logo moves all the way across the other side. Let's play. Okay, that's the basic movement for the playhead, but we will refine it and make it look a lot smoother in just a bit. But first, put a mask on the logo. That way, as the playhead moves to the left, it will gradually reveal the logo instead of showing everything at once. Let's grab a rectangle mask and connect it to our logo. Now jump to frame 40 and resize the rectangle so it completely covers the logo. Tick the invert back so the mask works the way we want. Add a keyframe on the center X value, then move forward about 20 frames. From here, adjust the center X so the rectangle slides all the way to the left, and you will see the logo gradually be revealed as it moves. Let's play. Okay, it needs a little polishing. Right now, the logo is showing up just a bit ahead of the playhead. So we will fix that to make the timing look perfect. But before we fix that timing issue, let's first refine the movement of the playhead. Right now, if you notice, the movement feels really plain. The playhead just starts right away, then stops all of a sudden, kind of abrupt. What we want is something more natural. So instead, the playhead should ease in slowly, pick up speed as it moves, reach its fastest point around the middle, and then slow down again as it comes to a stop. That way it feels smooth and more like how things move in real life. So select the transform node and open spline tool. This is where the magic happens. Make sure the transform node is checked and then hit zoom to fit. If the panel looks small, just resize it so you can see things clearly. Now you can see here how the movement looks really abrupt. Select both keyframes and press S on your keyboard. That instantly smooths out the animation, easing in and easing out. Let's hit play. Much better already. That's the quick and easy way. But if you want more precise control, you can grab these curve handles and shape the motion however you like. And yeah, that looks way better. Alright, now let's fix that timing issue. What we want is for the logo to be revealed right underneath the playhead as it moves to the left. Now let's jump back to the rectangle node and go to frame 40. Here is where we are going to fix that timing issue. What we will do is adjust the rectangle mask frame by frame so the logo only shows up right underneath the playhead. So just move forward one frame at a time and nudge the rectangle so that only the part of the logo to the right of the playhead is visible. Don't worry, it's just a few frames you will need to adjust. But doing it this way gives you the complete control over the timing and makes sure both the playhead and the logo stay perfectly in sync. Let's play it back. And yeah, that looks pretty good to me. Now I want the playhead to disappear right after it finishes revealing the logo. And then settle neatly between the I and P, because it belongs here. Select the transform node for the playhead and go to frame 60, right when the logo is fully revealed. From there, move about 10 frames forward. Using the center X and Y controls, or just by dragging the handle, bring the playhead in between the I and P, slightly above its final spot. Make sure it is nicely centered. Next, move another 5 frames forward and this time adjust the center Y values so the playhead drops into a proper position. Let's play. Okay, looks good, but here's the thing. We don't actually want to see the playhead floating above the logo and then sliding in. We just want that final settling movement to show. So we will refine it so the only the last motion is visible. Select the merge node and go to frame 2. Set the blend to 0 and add a keyframe. Move forward about 3 frames and bring the blend back to 1. Next, I'm gonna jump to frame 58, right where the logo is almost fully revealed, and add a keyframe. Now move forward 2 frames and drop the blend back to 0. From there, move forward 10 frames and add a keyframe again, but leave the value as it is. Finally, move 5 frames forward and bring the blend back to 1. Alright, let's play it back. And yeah, that's looking pretty good. Our logo animation is pretty much done, but since the playhead is the star of the animation, let's make it pop a little more. We already have a brightness contrast node connector, so select that. Go to frame 5 and add a keyframe. Then move about 15 frames forward and bring the gamma all the way down to 0. Now jump to frame 60 and bring the gamma back up to 1. From there, move 10 frames forward and add another keyframe without changing the value. Finally, move 5 frames forward and lower the gamma back to 0. Alright, let's play it back. And you can see now the playhead really stands out at the key moments. Now you know how to use keyframes to make the parts of the animation stand out. Let's do the same thing, but this time with the soft glow node on our logo. This will give the logo a nice glow effect right when the playhead slides between the I and P. So select the soft glow node and go to around frame 77. Set the gain to 0 and add a keyframe. Then move forward about 15 frames and bring the gain to around 0.4. and that's it. Now the logo gets a subtle cinematic glow exactly at the moment the playhead locks into place. Now there are tons of other things you could add here. Particles, extra effects, you name it. But honestly, at this point, we have already got a sleek, modern, and elegant logo animation. There's just one thing I would love for you to try on your own. Go through each node, open up the spline panel, select your keyframes, and hit S on your keyboard. That will smooth out the animation so nothing feels abrupt. You can save it as a macro so it's ready as a drag and drop template, or render it with a green screen or transparent background to reuse it in any future project. I hope you learned something new, and if you found this helpful, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more videos.